In this video, I show you how to configure email discovery for Windows Virtual Desktop clients. Hello, I'm Travis and this is Seraltos. So far, I've primarily used the web client when connecting to Windows Virtual Desktop in my videos. I started working with different remote desktop clients recently and realized that configuring the client with an email address is much easier than adding a URL. In this video, I'm going to walk through setting up email discovery for the remote desktop clients. Before that, please subscribe, like, share, and click the bell icon for new content. All of this can be done while maintaining social distancing. Email discovery has been around for some time with Windows remote desktop services. If you haven't used it before, here's how it works. The remote desktop client needs a URL to identify the location of a feed. The feed is a list of remote desktop resources available from the organization. With Windows remote desktop services, that URL was unique for each organization. Windows Virtual Desktop makes this much easier. Everyone uses the same URL. You can share the URL with end users, but who are we kidding? That would be difficult to manage. There's no way I'd remember it. Email discovery makes configuring the client much easier. Email discovery works by adding a text record to your organization's DNS. This is a value that points to the Windows Virtual Desktop feed. The user enters their email address into the remote desktop client instead of a URL. The client checks DNS for the email domain to see if the feed URL value exists. If it does, the client uses that URL in DNS to locate the Windows Virtual Desktop feed. For email feed discovery to work, a text record has to be added to DNS. The values for that text record are on the screen. There is a host record, that's what the client will search for, the text record, that's the feed URL, and a time to live value. The time to live can be higher than 300 if needed. Also, the URL listed on the screen is for the spring update version of Windows Virtual Desktop. Keep in mind that an entry has to be added to the email domain. So if the email address for the user is user1@seraltos.com, the entry has to be added to the seraltos.com DNS servers. And the user doesn't really need an email address for this to work. The remote desktop client just needs the domain name to find the text record. You could tell the users to use their UPN, but for most users, an email address is easier to communicate. Also, it's common to use different internal and external DNS servers. If that's the case, add the record to both DNS environments. Let's get started. In the demo, I'm going to walk through setting the external DNS entry in Network Solutions DNS services, and then do the same for my internal Windows DNS. Once that's finished, we'll test it. You will need admin rights to whatever system hosts DNS to make these changes. Let's start the demo. Let's begin. Let's start with the remote desktop client and try to add my feed. Notice that there's a subscribe option where users can just sign in. Not all remote desktop clients have that right now, say for iOS, for example. I'm going to use the subscribe with URL. Also, some versions of the remote desktop client have the option to add a computer or workspace. Use the add workspace for this. So I could add that URL if I wanted to, but that's not what this video is about. So if I add a user's email address, you'll notice it says it can't find a workspace associated with this email address. That's what we're going to fix. Also, I want to point out, way up here in the corner, there's an orange icon for remote desktop. The remote desktop version I'm using has this orange icon, not the version from the Microsoft App Store with the blue icon. That one doesn't work with Windows Virtual Desktop. Let's set up DNS next. Here I am in Network Solutions DNS settings. Now, there's a lot of different options for external DNS. You could host it with Windows. You could host it through Network Solutions, GoDaddy. Every place is going to be a little bit different in how this is done. So I'm just going to run through this as an example. And I'm going to go to Manage Advanced DNS Records. And if you have problems finding how to do this, check their help section and see how to add a text record in their DNS server. They're all kind of similar, so I'm going to add it here. And notice also I'm using Seraltos.net, not Seraltos.com. It's because there's a delay, and I want to get this video done in one day. So I already added this setting to Seraltos.com, but we're going to come in and show how to do it on a different domain. So here is my text record, and I'm going to edit text records. And here's where I'm going to add a text record. First, I'll add the host. And that's underscore MSRADC. Now, I can try to set the time to live to 300, which is what Microsoft recommends, but it's not going to take it. I'll try anyway. And then I'm going to add this URL. That's the URL to the Windows Virtual Desktop feed. I'll click Continue. Okay, and it says the smallest amount we can go is 3600. So this is the time that DNS servers hold this information in the cache before it does a new lookup. So it really doesn't matter. I'll just add 3600 and move on with our lives. Here it says it can take up to 24 hours for the update to replicate throughout the whole interwebs. So I'm going to save changes. And here it says 24 to 48. Normally it only takes, you know, half an hour or so, but it all depends on where you're updating it and where you're coming from. That is how you add a text record for the email feed through Network Solutions, and any other external DNS provider like this should be pretty similar. We can do a test quick by opening the command prompt, and I'll run an NSLookup against the type text for that record we just added. So that didn't take long at all. And if you're lucky enough, it won't take yours long at all either, but it could take even longer. That all depends on the system you're working on. The actual replication time is typically out of our control. Okay, let's set up internal DNS. And this assumes that your internal DNS is Windows AD DNS. If not, you'll need to find your DNS admin and have them help you. If you're the DNS admin, then that shouldn't be a problem. So I'm going to find my zone, which is seraltos.com. Right-click, Other New Records. I'm going to scroll down to Text. Create Record. And the name will be that host name. And the text will be the feed URL. I'll click OK. And done. Then at the bottom here, we can see it was added. If I hop over to a command prompt, I'm going to do an NSLookup for that same record, but at seraltos.com. And again, this is testing my internal DNS. And there it is. So the record's coming back. I'm just going to minimize this. Here we are back at the external command prompt. I'm going to run the same command again, but this time against .com, just to make sure it's there. So what I'm doing here is I don't have a Windows Virtual Desktop at seraltos.net. It's at seraltos.com. I was just using that as an example of how to add an external DNS record for this demo. But they're both listed now, so let's go back to the client. I'm going to subscribe with the URL. And this time I'm going to add my email address. And you can see it's finding that workspace URL. So now I'll click Next. And I'll sign in. And I'm going to uncheck this. And there we go. It found my workspace. That's it for the demo. That's how we set up Windows Virtual Desktop email feed discovery on an internal and external domain. I hope that makes it easier for your users to access Windows Virtual Desktop. If so, please subscribe, like, and all that jazz. Thanks for watching.